which when represented in decimal base does not end with 0. Z and the number obtained by reversing the digits of the Z are both multiple of 7 here. And let the number of Z in the set from 10 to 1000. So basically we need to count all the 2 digit and 3 digit number. There is only one 4 digit number, 1000, which is definitely not a multiple of 7 here. So if I am counting a 2 digit number, okay. So can you see all the 2 digit number, it will be in the form of AB, which is equal to 10A plus B. And if I reverse the digit, then it will be equal to BA, and that will be equal to 10B plus A. So AB is a multiple of 7 as well as BA is also a multiple of 7. And we need to identify how many such 2 digit numbers are there. So can we say if the 2 numbers are multiple of 7, then their sum is a multiple of 7 as well as difference is also a multiple of 7. So what I can say here, that is AB minus BA. So if I take a difference of these two terms, it will be comes out to be 9 times A minus B. And it has to be a multiple of 7. So as 9 is not a multiple of 7, remember that we can't divide 9 by 7. So 9 into A minus B is a multiple of 7. That is only possible if A minus B, it is a multiple of 7. Let me write down 7k. Similarly, the sum of two numbers, that is AB plus BA, it has to be also a multiple of 7. So it will be AB plus BA. If you add these two values, it will be equal to 11 times A plus B. Now, if 11 times A plus B is a multiple of 7, 11 can't be a multiple of 7. So which means A plus B should be a multiple of 7. So from here, we can say that A plus B is also a multiple of 7. So let me write down, let's say 7x here. So we are basically looking for two single digit number such that their difference is a multiple of 7 as well as sum is also a multiple of 7 here. Alright. So we can start making the cases how many such numbers are possible here. So if I am talking about the difference, one of the case, A plus B is a multiple of 7. So I can say, let's say 1, 6. But is the difference A minus B, it is a multiple of 7, 1 minus 6? No. I can say A plus B, or I can say probably 2 plus 5. Or I can say 3 plus 4, which is a multiple of 7. But whether the difference of A minus B is also a multiple of 7, it can be positive, negative, it doesn't matter. It has to be a multiple of 7. So 1 minus 6, in this case, the difference is coming out to be minus 5. 2 minus 5, minus 3. 3 minus 4, minus 1. So none of these values are satisfying. Okay. Similarly, I can say 4 plus 10. Of course, B can't be equal to 10. But you can say, okay, let's take 5 and 9, all right? 5 plus 9, it is 14. 14 is also a multiple of 7. But again, this case won't be possible here. Okay, because 5 minus 9 is minus 4, not possible. Similarly, we can say 6 and 8. 6 plus 8 is 14, but 6 minus 8 is minus 2, which is not a multiple of 7. But if I take 7 and 7, so 7 plus 7 is a multiple of 4. 7 and 7 minus 7 is a 0, which is also a multiple of 7. And that's it. So there is only one 2-digit number which is satisfying this condition. And what is that 2-digit number? That 2-digit number is nothing but 77. Because if the number is 77 and if you reverse it again, I'll get 77. So both of them are multiple of 7. So there is only one 2-digit number. After 7 and 7, if you count, then it will be again 8 plus 6 here, which is a multiple of 14. But 6 and 8 and 8 and 6 are more or less same thing here. So I just check only till 7 and 7. So there is only one 2-digit number which is satisfying this condition. And that 2-digit number is what? 77. So I can write down one of the number is 77. Now, similarly, let's try to identify how many 3-digit numbers are satisfying these conditions here. Now, we know that all 3-digit numbers, it can be written in the form of A, B, C. And if I reverse it, then it will be nothing but that is C, B, A. So, A, B, C, it is equal to 100A plus 10B plus C. And C, B, A is equal to 100C plus 10B plus A. And if you take a difference, that is ABC minus CBA. So in that case, 100A minus A, that is 99 times A minus C. And this number must be a multiple of 7. But 99 is not divisible by 7. Okay, this number 99 into a minus c is a multiple of 7. That is only possible if a minus c, it is a multiple of 7. So I am writing down 7k. Similarly, their sum, that is abc plus cba, it should be also a multiple of 7. So if I add both of them, I'll get that is equal to 101 times a plus c and plus 20b. So 7, I can say this is equal to, what is the nearest multiple of 7? Closer to 101. So I can say 13 into 7 is 14 into 7, 98. So 98 times a plus c plus thrice of a plus c plus 20b, I can write down 21b minus b. Now this entire number is a multiple of 7. If this entire number is a multiple of 7, which means 98 into a plus c, it is already a multiple of 7. 21b is already a multiple of 7. So which means that 3 times a plus c minus b, it should be a multiple of 7. So I'm writing down as a 7x. Okay. And then we need to identify what are the possible values here. Okay. What are the possible values which can satisfy these conditions here? So we just need to do a counting. So let's start counting here. Now a plus b, c should be a multiple of minus b, it has to be a multiple of 7. Now if I'm saying a minus c is a multiple of 7, what are the different possibilities here? All right. So I can say a minus c, probably we can take a number like which number? Or I can say 7 and 0, not possible. Remember a and c, the leading digit can't be 0 here. So I'll say 8 minus 1. Okay, so 8 minus 1 is a 7, all right? Or I can say that is equal to 9 minus 2, it is equal to 7, all right? So 8 minus 1 and 9 minus 2. In addition to this, we can also take, if the numbers are different, then I can say 8 minus 1, 9 minus 2, it is a multiple of 7. Or can I say that is 1 minus 1, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 3, 4 minus 4, and so on till 9 minus 9. I can take these values also. Now, with respect to 8 minus 1, what is a plus c? Now, it doesn't matter here. A plus c, it is always going to be 8 plus 1, 9. So, this is 3 into 9, that is 27. So, 27 minus b, it has to be a multiple of 7. So, from here, you can say the possible values of b is equal to what? I can say 6, isn't it? 27 minus 6, it is equal to 21, which is a multiple. Remember that b is a single digit number. So from here, we have got two cases. That is 8, 6, 1. That is the original number. Or 1, 6, 8, if I reverse it. So 8, 6, 1. And if I reverse it, I'll get 1, 6, 8. Or if the original number is 1, 6, 8, if I reverse it, it is 8, 6, 1. Similarly, this is 9 and 2. So a plus c is 9 plus 2 is 11. 11 into 2 is 33. 33 minus b, it has to be a multiple of 7. So what are values of b are there? So I think if I subtract 5, 33 minus 5 is 28, which is a multiple of 7. So the value of b is equal to 5. So here we can say the numbers are 952 or 259. There are two possibilities here. Now, in the next case, I'll say that is 1 and 1. A and C are 1 and 1. So, 1 plus 1 is 2. 3 into 2 is 6. 6 minus B, it has to be a multiple of 7. So, B must be equal to 6. Okay. 6 minus 6 is 0, which is a multiple of 6. So, I'll get the number only 101. Similarly, if I say 2 and 2. Alright. 2 and 2 also. So, if it is 2 and 2, I can say that is equal to 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 into 3 is 12, and 12 minus b, it has to be a multiple of what? 7. So b is equal to 5. That is the only possibilities. So I can say the number is nothing but that is 252. Similarly, 3 and 3. So 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 into 3 is 18 minus b, it has to be a multiple of 7. So b, it has to be equal to 4. So I'll get the next number, that is 343. So here b is equal to 4, here b is equal to 5. If I take 4 and 4, so 4 plus 4 is 8, 8 threes are 24. So 24 minus b has to be a multiple of 7. So B is equal to 3. So I'll get the next number that is equal to 4, 3, 4. Okay. Similarly, if I take 5 and 5, so 5 plus 5 is 10. 10 into 3 is 30. 30 minus B has to be a multiple of 7. So the only possible values of B, it has to be equal to what? 30 minus B. So 2, B can be equal to 2, as well as B can be equal to 9. So here you need to be careful. In this case, B can be equal to 2 as well as 9. 30 minus 2 is 28. And 30 minus 9 is 21 also. Alright, 2 plus 7, 9. So there are two possibilities here. I can say the two possibilities are 5, 2, 5 and 5, 9, 5. Then when you take 6 and 6, so A plus C is 12. 12 into 3 is 36 minus B. And if 36 minus B is a multiple of 7, so what are the possible values of B? One of the values of B is equal to 1. Alright, 36 minus 1 is 35. And next possible value of B is 8 also. 36 minus 8 is 28. So when A plus C, when A and C are 6 and 6, we are getting two possibilities. That is 616 and 686. Similarly, when A and C are 7 and 7, so 7 plus 7 is 14. 14 into 3 is 42. Alright? So I'm writing down here, when A and C are 7 and 7, then we'll get 14 into 3 is 42. So 42 minus B. So in that case, only possibility of B is equal to 0 and 7. 42 minus 0 is a multiple of 42. 42 minus 7. 42 minus 7 will be equal to 35, which is again a multiple of 7. So when A and C are 7, we are getting two possibilities. That is 7, 0, 7 and 7, 7, 7. Similarly, when A and C are 8, so 8 plus 8 is 16 into 3, 48 minus B, it has to be a multiple of 7. So one of the value of B is equal to 6, 48 minus 6 is 42, which is a multiple of 7. Only one value, because next value is 6 plus 7, 13, which is a two-digit number and which won't be possible. So there is only one number. So 48 minus B is a multiple of 7, the value of B is equal to 6 here. So if B is equal to 6 and A and C we have taken as 8 and 8. So only one possibility, that is 8, 6 and 8. And last, if A and C are 9 and 9. 9 minus 9 is 0, which is a multiple of 7. And 9 plus 9 is 18. 18 into 3 is 54. So 54 minus B, it has to be a multiple of 7. Okay. So what number I should say, subtract here. So 7 into 7 is 49. So B is equal to 5. From here, B is equal to 5. 54 minus 5 is 49, which is a multiple of 7. So last number is 959. So these are the only possibilities. So if you count, how many numbers are there in total? I can say there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So the correct answer for this question is option D, which is 16. A difficult question, but yes, you should know how to do a counting here. That is very, very important. What should be the correct approach to do a counting? So that instead of using a guesswork, we can follow this method in a structured way to get the desired result here. Thank you.